And we are back here live in Las Vegas, where we're just 2 days away from a very big moment in this presidential process, the last presidential debate. Some early voting data is starting to roll in because, you know, quite a few people have already voted. As of this hour, more than 1.4 million Americans are done with the voting process. They have cast their ballots. And from what we're seeing so far, the numbers show that Donald Trump is set to do better in the battleground states of Iowa and Ohio than Mitt Romney did in those states in 2012. So let's dig into some of these numbers. Dr. Michael McDonald works with the United States Elections Project to gather those numbers. He's an associate professor at the University of Florida. Michael, welcome. Good to have you here today.
Great to be with you.
So what, when you look at these numbers, you've got 1.4 million, you don't know who these people voted for, but you know what party they're affiliated with, and that gives you some indications?
Yeah, some states have party registration that we know how the early voters have voted by their party registration. Other states may have age, race, or gender also on their voter files, and we can look at some of the clues that we might get from those states as well.
All right, so as we pointed out in the introduction, there are a couple states that, Ohio and Iowa, where Donald Trump is doing better. I don't know really what that gets you in the end, though. You know, if he wins those states bigger than Mitt Romney did, he's going to win those states. He'll win the electoral votes for those states, right?
Yeah, so it's very interesting election that we've got going on here. Usually when we see the election move, it moves all in one direction, all at the same time. So think like 2008 with Obama winning places like Indiana and North Carolina, which were at the time not places that you'd really expect the Democrats to do well. This election's different. We're seeing strength for Clinton in places like North Carolina again, Florida and Virginia. But at the same time, even if those states are moving in the direction of the Democrats, we're seeing direction in the movement of the Republicans in the Midwest in places like Iowa and Ohio. Very fascinating election.
It is, because, you know, when you look across electoral history, you know, but, you know, as part of the what we're talking about to the viewers as well, you can see these shifts, you know, when the South moves from Republican to Democratic, and you see these, you know, sort of at wide junctures across the course of history. Are we seeing that now? And while we you answer that, let's pull up the southern states, because you've got Florida, North Carolina, and Virginia, where Hillary Clinton appears to be doing better in those states than Barack Obama did back in 2012.
Yeah, absolutely. So, again, it's just a fascinating example. Now, is this a long-term adjustment, which political scientists like myself, we call that a realigning election, or is this just a deviating election, a one-off on this particular election cycle? We'll have to wait and see, but it is very curious to see these divergent patterns throughout the country that could spell some real fundamental changes in our politics.
Now, you said you also break them down by gender, and you saw a surge of women requesting absentee ballots after that first debate. What does that tell you?
Yeah, there are two states, North Carolina and Georgia, where I have individual level data by gender of people who have requested and returned their absentee ballots. And I could see in that week following the first presidential debate, there was a surge in women who were requesting their absentee ballots. Now, it was just a small surge, and in the big scheme of things, it's there'll be millions of votes in those states, and we're only seeing maybe thousands of people that were engaged in requesting absentee ballots. But it is interesting to see that sort of effect where a campaign event happens, and you can actually see the voters respond to those events.
Right. And that, of course, was in the wake of the videotape that came out and the subsequent allegations that came out as well. Whether or not there's a link between those two things, you don't know for sure, obviously, at this point. But let me just ask you a quick Florida question, because it shows how many Democrats and Republicans have voted in the absentee ballots, but you don't have a handle on crossover. And the Florida Republicans say that they believe there's a lot of sort of shy Trump vote out there, Democrats that are crossing over. Any indication that that's true?
This is very important to understand. All we can look at this point are the party registration of the people who are voting. Usually the Republicans have about a 3 percentage point lead. That's what they had in 2012 in absentee ballots in Florida. Right now, out of 500,000 votes that have been cast so far that have been returned to election officials, Republicans lead by 34. So that's very interesting. I think there's some things that we need to see that shake out, because there's some Republicans area of the state that were hit by the hurricane that aren't voting at the same rates as they did in 2012. So we need to be a little cautious on those numbers yet.
Yeah. You have some good numbers. Interesting stuff to look at, Michael. Thank you very much for being with us today. We appreciate it.
You're welcome.